We're back. Let's see if we can get these angelonias whipped into shape here. So I begin by using, again, this is magenta plus white. I start just adding the little petals in. And the secret to this, again, is keeping that brush clean. As I paint over the green, I pick up some of that green on the brush, so I have to be just very careful to keep your brush clean. And I leave those darks in the backs of that because that's helps give depth to the flowers. And I'm just laying the paint on. Now these in the back are going to be a little darker. But I want to make a middle mixture here. This is my magenta plus white. That's just a really pretty color. It's perfect for flowers. Now this one I'm going to make a little taller since it's right here on the edge. But these in here I'm going to keep fairly short. In fact, that's the very top of it. I'm going to let a little light hit there again. These are not in light per se, but they still have some variation in the values in the flowers. And I just kind of let the brush dance on the canvas. It's not a whole lot of real rhyme or reason. I don't follow my reference exactly. I look at my reference to get the general anatomy of the plants, the flowers, and then I just let the brush, I follow the brush. Now I'm going to make this a little bit lighter here so it comes in front of that dark nasturtium behind it. Come back here with a little green. I'm going to use some of my green to shape around that nasturtium. I'm going to take out, I had a blossom, an angelonia blossom coming up in here, but I don't like that. I'm going to take that one out. So we see that our nasturtium blossom in there. Now I'm going to just do a few little angelonia leaves in there. The flowers are sort of intertwining where they come together in the planter. I want that flower to be dark. And another one here. And then this is going to be dark in here too. Almost too dark. There we go. Get those blossoms there. And I'm cleaning my brush out in my thinner and then I wipe it dry. That's coming in front of those. This one is also going to be lighter. My lighter mixture here so it pops forward. But you can see how that gives texture to these flowers. Lighter mixture just to accent a few of the petals. And I'm just adding, this is magenta plus white. This one's here. Dips down a little lower. These in the front are going to be a little lighter since they're against a dark in here, and then the ones in the background are going to be darker since they're against that light water. But I still want some variation in the different values of the petals. Again, I just kind of let my brush dance on the canvas. These are going to be a little lighter. I'm going to make this one back here. These are a little bit lighter. Google is a wonderful place to find reference material. If I'm looking for a specific type of flower, I can put in that. Like I can, for these, I can put in Angelonia. Or if I'm just wanting, if I want to have a place where I want some red flowers, I'll just go to Google Images and put in red flowers. And it comes up with all kinds of different flowers that gives me ideas. And comes up with, I tend to use the same flowers over and over if I'm just left to my own devices. So by searching out a flower color, I am introduced to all kinds of different flowers. You know, we get ideas everywhere. And it's just fun to look and search and learn. I find pictures of flowers, I'm not sure what they are, and so I'll ask my readers in my blog, do you know what this flower is? And most of the time, somebody will say, oh yes, that's us so-and-so. It's a lot of fun. And also, if you ever have questions, feel free to make them in the comments section. I'll be happy to answer. If I don't know, I'll say I don't know, but hopefully I can help you. God has so blessed Jack and I as artists, and he helped artists all over the world through the internet. He suggested I start a blog to help artists. And so when he passed away, I figure it was my duty to just continue his legacy of giving back to artists and helping. That we're all in this together. And if we can help each other, that's so much better than not helping. God's given us a gift. We should share it. Share our knowledge. I'm going to put some little stems in here. As they come up above the foliage. Here I'm going to have some dark ones so you can see it well. And the Angelonias also have little, some of them are not all the way blooming. I guess that's the right way to say it. The flowers haven't totally come out. So they have little buds at the tops of some of the blooms. And so we're going to add those in. Add a few little leaves here breaking out. This guy needs to have a little more light on him. Comes out in front of the nasturtiums, same here. I'm going to put another couple of leaves right in there. Okay, so here's how we're going to do the little flower buds. And they're not on all of them, but some of them just have a little almost like a hollyhock, not as tall. Just these little flower buds. And doing things like this just gives your flowers a little more authenticity, I guess. I'm not sure the right word, but make them look more anatomically correct. And since I started out as a medical illustrator, it's inherent in my personality to make my flowers and horses, whatever. I'm a stickler for anatomy. Now I'm making the little buds here lighter so that they stand out in front of that dark. We'll put some in this one too. And I'm even going to have a couple of those just starting to pop out. It's just fun. I don't like that dark. I don't like this light up here. I'm going to put some leaves in there. There we go. That was just too bright. So now I'm going to have some little buds in here. But you can see it's not on every flower, but it's... We'll do one. Let this guy have some. I was thinking about making them light, but I think I'll make them dark here. And this one will have some. Now, flowers always drop petals, unless somewhere has been freshly swept or blown, you're going to have some petals. So we just drop a few little flower petals down here. This always makes it fun. And even a couple have popped over here. We don't have a floor to put them on, so we'll put them on the windowsill. We'll do the nasturtiums in the next part. So I hope you come back. Thank you for watching my YouTube videos. I also have a blog where I have the link to the description. The link to the blog is in the description below. And it's also the address is on the final frame of my video. So I hope you'll come back. And thank you again for visiting the studio.